Before telling you this incredible story, I would like to make a small digression and travel back several centuries, at a time when hunting was only a way to provide food. In those days, no one thought that there was any other goal to go into the forest with a gun. Hunting was a necessity, hard work, to which people were pushed only by the feeling of hunger. What do we see today? Hunting is no longer a necessity. Any food can be bought at the supermarket, including meat from special farms. People no longer have to pick up a gun and go to the forest to feed themselves. Hunting is now more of a hobby, a kind of entertainment for people. When this happens, sometimes nature is forced to put people in their place. It happened in a deep taiga forest where four young people went to hunt defenseless animals. At the beginning of hunting season, they regularly went out into the forest in order to shoot something. In fact, it was not important for them what they shot. The main thing was that it was a live target. When the men arrived at the place of their camp, they laid out all their belongings, set up tents, made a fire, and started cooking food to refresh themselves before the hunt. When the food was almost ready, they felt like they were being watched. They noticed that in the thickets of trees, some animal was stirring. Without a moment's hesitation, the men grabbed their guns and quickly rushed to catch up with the animal. Their secret observer turned out to be a small gray wolf pup following the scent of cooking food. Of course, no one was going to feed the helpless pup, but instead, one of the hunters quickly loaded his gun and shot in his direction. The poor animal only had time to cry out in fright and rushed headlong to escape from its pursuers. The men, with loud laughter and shouts, started following him. When the wolf pup was exhausted and stopped to catch his breath, four guns aimed at him at once and fired almost simultaneously. What was the surprise of the men when the wolf pup, as if by magic, dodged the bullets and kept running? This was repeated several times. The men shot at the beast, but never got him. Soon, they got bored with this fruitless pursuit and decided to return to their camp to eat and rest. When they looked around, they realized that they had no idea where they were. So carried away by the pursuit of the wolf pup, they got lost in the taiga forest. The men started wandering through the forest, hoping to find the way back to their camp. They spent about 3 hours searching, but it seemed that they only went deeper into the forest. It was getting dark, and the men began to worry. It was at that moment that they stumbled upon an old dilapidated hut at the edge of the forest. Coming closer to it, they thought that they would have to spend the night there because wandering through the dark forest was very dangerous. But then suddenly, the door of the hut opened and an elderly man came out of it. The hunters caught their breath when they saw the man there in the middle of the taiga wilderness, but they were even more surprised when they saw behind his legs that very wolf pup they were chasing all this time. The elderly man looked at the four armed men with reproach and politely asked why they were chasing a small defenseless pup. But the men, clearly feeling superior, threatened him if he interfered with their business and prevented them from doing what they liked. The elderly man just shook his head and went back into the hut. This act annoyed the men so much that they decided to take revenge on him. But it was at this moment that something so incredible happened that it is hard to believe. Suddenly, a strong wind started blowing. The cloudless sky was instantly filled with black thunderclouds. It started raining heavily, which very quickly turned to hail the size of quail eggs. The hail painfully lashed the men on their heads and backs, and the wind blew so hard that it literally blew them off their feet. They screamed desperately and called the elderly man for help, but the wind was so strong that it instantly drowned out their voices. This was going on for several minutes, and then it all ended as unexpectedly as it started. The clouds dispersed, the sun came out, and only the broken branches of the trees indicated what had happened. When the men came to their senses, the four of them were lying on the ground holding each other. There were no guns nearby. Apparently, a strong wind took them somewhere far. But that was not what panicked the four friends. With great bewilderment, they discovered that the hut was no longer there, as if they were dreaming all of it. The men were overwhelmed by such fear that they took each other by the hands and started sobbing like little children. They did not understand what was happening, where the elderly man had gone. They felt as if some unknown force was watching them and taking revenge on them for all their previous actions. With loud cries of despair, they did not know where to run. For a long time, they ran through the forest in search of a road until they accidentally found their camp. The men frantically collected all their things. They spent the night sitting back to back, afraid to close their eyes even for a minute. And as soon as the first morning light fell on the forest, they grabbed their belongings and ran away from the dense forest. They never again took up their guns to hunt. This is how nature showed the hunters that she too can stand up for herself, protecting her defenseless inhabitants. Of course, there are a lot of questions in this story, and there are practically no answers. Why couldn't four experienced shooters hit one little wolf pup? Who was that elderly man, and where did he come from? Why did the sudden hurricane happen? And most importantly, where did the hut go, which four adult men clearly saw? Do you think there is a place for such inexplicable things in our lives? Share your opinion in the comments, click like, subscribe to the channel, and we will continue to tell you the most interesting and incredible stories. See you next time.